We could also use things like voting inside of Miro to sort of help narrow the field down just a little bit from all the sticky notes that we've created to the couple that we want to move over to.
Okay, well, let's go back to our example output and use this elusive voting feature you have. Now, as I zoom in on my features, I'm actually going to focus on resources just because that's an area that I could lose some feedback on. So let's go ahead and focus, Megan, on our resources. Our resource section was where we inventoried all the things we have at our disposal. But to your point, that might be a list of literally thousands. If I had traversed my way via the internet and looked on major shopping sites, there's no limitation to the number of chairs, right? Or the type of smart monitor that I could ultimately have. So I'm gonna go ahead and click what looks like a square with a couple of dots on it, which is the voting button. I'm then going to be able to set the number of votes. In this case, we'll keep it at 3 and the amount of time that you and I have to do it. In fact, we're going to do a speed round, Megan, and only make this 1 minute by adjusting the minus sign. Then we're going to actually not turn on the limitation on voting per object. So if you want to use all 3 of your votes on the same post-it note, you really believe in shorter working hours, like I'll weigh in on, we're going to have to find ourselves on the board.
I'm
going to
vote for all of my ideas.
All of your ideas. We also have the ability to limit the number of things that someone can vote on a board. So if I only want people to be able to cast votes, in this case, on sticky notes, I can go ahead and select that before I click the start button. Once I click the start button, I can go ahead and choose to opt into the voting. This allows everyone to join you when they are ready, as opposed to forcing people from what they are doing into the starting function. By clicking join, I'm going to now see that I have, in fact, the ability to click any of the plus signs on any of the post-it notes. So I am going to vote for shorter working hours and then replace with 2 votes my cheap chair for a good one. I've been holding out forever and ever. I'm going to wait a couple of extra seconds, even though we had a minute, but I can tell that Megan's already done voted, and I'm going to go ahead and click end for everyone. Now I'm going to end my session and ultimately wait for my results to be prepared. It turns out, in a really simple and nearly instantaneous way, I now can understand that actually there was 4 votes on the cheap chair with a nicer one replacement mechanism, and only 1 vote for shortening working hours and ultimately sitting in a healthier manner, putting my shoulders back and up over the period of time. If I click see results, I'll ultimately expand outward and again have a visual orientation of where I'm at. I can edit, label, or of course delete this voting session and ultimately bring new voting sessions as many times as I would like.